I enjoyed making The Life of Eric Zahn, but in retrospect, the existential atmospheric horror thing might benefit more from a properly paced narrative than an arcade infinite gameplay model. The spooky set piece at the start of each night is pretty cool the first time, kinda getting old after 10 nights. I think if I were doing this as a long-term project, I'd want to focus on the setting, give Eric Zahn more responsibilities and things to do in town during the day, characters to meet with their own arcs, something a bit Reseteer-esque, so the player can get a feel for what's at stake as they struggle to keep the world alive. As it stands, most of the daytime activity just boils down to click to do thing, click again to stop doing thing, although I did come up with what I hope is an interesting mechanic to make the studying a bit more fun. At the start of each study session, the player has to pick two keywords from the documents they've already unlocked. They get a study speed bonus based on how relevant the keywords are to the situation, and an extra big bonus if it's a word combo they haven't used before. Hopefully this motivates the player to engage with the setting, and along with the randomized busking income, to also add an X factor that means you can't get by just from evenly portioning out the day between sleep, study, and busking. How it works is the text string that makes up each document has a score from 1 to 3 in front of each relevant word. The game's code extracts each word separately, strips the number off the word with the string digits function, and then displays only the letters with the string letters function. Which meant I couldn't use numerical digits as part of the text, but that's easy enough to work around. Also, the character at the start of each string informs the code whether to display in the handwriting font or the typewriter font before stripping that off as well. Packaging information in the string like this means it can all be nicely, tidily filed under a single variable. See, I do know how to keep things tidy, mum. So, time to draw a line under Eric Zahn. Give it a download, and let me know what you think. I think the game over sequence turned out pretty well. It uses a sound effect, custom made by myself, from a harsh electronic feedback noise mixed with the sound of a chicken being strangled to death. Anyway, Project 4 is out the door, so Project 5 must come alive. Previously in this series, I've banged on about focusing on the primary gameplay loop to make sure first and foremost that we have an interesting thing for the player to do from moment to moment. In response, some of you have asked me how one goes about coming up with an interesting primary loop, and that's a difficult question to answer. A hair's breadth from the eternal creative's nightmare question, where do you get your ideas? I don't know, you just think them up. But one thing you could do to spark the old inspiration is look to things that people find cathartic or exciting or impressive and try to break them down to their simplest possible forms while still retaining what makes them engaging. So a fight scene or a gun battle in a movie where a hero decks baddie after baddie is fun to watch, and from that most combat-based game loops can be derived. It's cathartic to watch a ski jumper or gymnast make a perfect landing, and we might use that to inform platforming mechanics. Hell, going for a nice long piss is cathartic, and that's presumably where Super Mario Sunshine came from. But let's get back to combat, and specifically martial arts. Nothing quite like watching a skilled fighter flowing stylishly from one crushed motherfucker to the next, and indeed there are no end of games that try to recreate that, but the specific martial art that crept into my head meets, like a caterpillar into a ham sandwich, is gun katar. That thing Christian Bale does in the movie Equilibrium that's like martial arts but he's got a gun in each hand. No, it isn't practical or realistic. Dual wielding never is. You can't aim two guns at once, smart guy, unless you've got two heads. But damn if it isn't fun to watch. So, let's break it down for the purpose of a simple primary loop. And I think that there are two core principles at work here. Flamboyant aim switching with lots of spinning around, broken up by single precisely aimed gunshots. Now, precision is easy enough to reward in a shooter. You'd be hard-pressed to find a shooter model that doesn't reward precision, but what about the other part, the spinning around a lot? How would we apply that principle to, say, a top-down shooter? Actually, let's get the blueprint in on this. Say the player character's facing two enemies next to each other and needs to shoot them both dead-like. The standard, efficient way would be to shoot one, rotate slightly to the right, and shoot the other. The flamboyant gun katar method would be to rotate the other way, shoot one, do an almost complete turn, then shoot the other. I'm proposing that we incentivize the player to take the more flamboyant option, so how do we do that? Well, we could come up with a system that awards points for stylishness, like you see in spectacle fighters like Devil May Cry. But that feels like adding a fifth wheel to a perfectly functional skateboard, and I'd rather a more organic solution. My thinking is to give the player two guns that always point in opposite directions and incentivize them to switch between the two. Maybe they fire alternately, so after firing one you have to turn around and use the other. That's one solution, but I like it less than my next one. What if we take a leaf out of Ikaruga's book and say enemy A can only be killed with gun A, and enemy B can only be killed with gun B, colour coding the guns and enemies accordingly? So here's the plan. Top-down view of your dude, arms akimbo, enemies of two colours encroaching from all sides. You move around with the usual controls and have two fire buttons, one for each gun. You also have one button for rotate left and another for rotate right. Hold down a rotate button to keep rotating, but when you release it, your dude will keep rotating until one of their guns is aiming at an enemy. Hopefully having this snap aim feature will compensate for the extra thinking time required for making sure you're shooting the right gun at the right dude. Oh, but I guess it wouldn't cost me anything to add an option that disables snap aim if you're really hardcore. That's all very well, Yahtzee, but why are you calling it Hogpocalypse Sow? Well, the rotational color-coded shooting is the gameplay loop, but we also need a theme. A context. I think that was Upbeat's problem, it was all loop and no theme. For that, I looked to current events. You see, during the recent gun control debate that followed a brace of shootings in America, a brave individual on Twitter stood up for his right to own ridiculously powerful firearms by calling attention to the problem of wild hogs in rural America, where landowners are apparently forced to wage permanent defensive warfare against veritable armies of feral pigs that are constantly attacking in what can only be described as apocalyptic numbers. I had no idea such pitched conflict for our very lives was taking place on the home front. It's nothing less than my civic duty to memorialize the struggle of these courageous men and women by making a game about flamboyantly shooting the living fuck out of hordes of undomesticated pigs, all of which have been inexplicably color-coded. Just as long as none of them are red, white, or blue, yeah?
Hello, I'm Samantha Nelson, managing editor of Escapist Magazine. I'm helping Yahtzee with his Dev Diary series this week by playing and appraising the life of Eric Zahn. So, starting up a new game here. I was a little confused at first. I thought that these health bars were kind of akin to a fighting game where you had your health on the left and the monster's health on the right, but that is actually not the case. While your health is on the left, the right is your inspiration, which is expended by playing your violin. As we can see, the stars have stopped, and we have this nice, cute little town that's oblivious to the horrors that I've kept at bay for the night. So I'm going to study. B plus. Well, I'll take it. So I'm in okay shape for my money. Oh ye blackest, ocean floating, its eyes open, staring, doting, without caring, white as bone, cold as light, and not alone. Well, that's creepy. Yeah,